Let's set up Blender 3.0 for 3D printing and precision modeling. If it's the first time you're running Blender, you'll have this introductory splash screen. I would suggest that you change your spacebar to search, but I'll show you how to do that in just a moment. I'll hit next and then I'll click on the background. We can see that everything looks really small and fine, and it looks like we're in meters as well, so let's sort all of this out. Let's go to Edit, then Preferences, and the first thing I want to do is right here where it says Resolution Scale, I'm going to change that to 1.25 because I'm working on a 4K screen. It'll make everything a lot more visible. Now, I also like to change my line width over to thick, as it just makes everything even more visible still. Then I'll go to System and I'll crank my undo steps to the maximum amount. Now, if you missed that splash screen, let's go to Key Map, and here where it says Spacebar Action, by default it'll be on Play. I would suggest go for Search because we don't do a lot of playing when we're doing precision modeling. Then let's click on the burger stack, hit Save Preferences, because I have had times that it doesn't auto-save. Clicking out of there, we're going to go to our scene properties right here. We're going to go to our units, and we're going to change our length from meters to millimeters. Now be careful, when we press N to open up our side menu, we've changed the representation of the units to millimeters, not the actual global scale of it. To do that, we need to go to unit scale and set that to 0.001, and now the unit scale has changed to millimeters. But our overlays have gone, so let's go to our overlays. They have their own scale option right here, and we're going to change that to 0.001 so that they reflect our unit scale. Then I'm going to turn on my statistics, because I like to have a little bit extra information. And down here on my bottom bar, I'm also going to turn on my statistics. I'm going to turn on my video memory, my system memory, and my statistics right there. Okay, now if we zoom out, you can see that things are going to start clipping out really quickly. That is due to our clipping plane. Let's go to our view, and these numbers right here, that's our clipping plane. I set this to 0.1, and I like to put in two zeros for my end. And now you can see we can see a lot more of what's inside of our plane. Now let's set up our scene how we want it to be every single time we start a new general file. So I like to have this over in item. I also like to have this over in my active tool. But there's one other thing. Inside of edit mode, this is set up like this. My lines are really small and fine. My vertices are just a little bit too small, and my lines are black. I like to have them a different color. So I'm going to go to Edit, Preferences, then I'm going to go to my themes right here. I'll find my 3D viewport, and I'm going to change my wire edit. This one here, I'll click on this little arrow, bring this up to a nice bright blue like so. Then I'll scroll all the way down to where I get my vertex size and like to change this to a minimum of 4. I will save my preferences once again and click out of there, and you'll see how much more contrast there is with that, especially when you're working with individual vertices in such a manner like that. Okay, going out of edit mode with tab, let's select everything because I don't want to start up with all of this every single time. I also like to have that in tool, and I always like to have that closed down. So the crucial part here is to go to File, then Defaults, Save Startup File, and confirm that saving. If you do not do that, every single time that you go File, New, and Create a New General, it will put everything back to how it was. Your units would still be in meters and it wouldn't be in millimeters. So make sure you save everything you've done once you've set it up how you like it. Now that you're all set up with Blender, you might be looking to learn more. Well, I have an entire free precision-driven course here on YouTube. It's over 10 hours long, very technically deep, but you only make one tiny little model in it. However, if you're looking to learn Blender through actually making 3D printing projects, head on over to Maker Tales Academy, where you learn everything you need to know in Blender for 3D printing. All the links for everything I've just mentioned are going to be down in the description. And a huge thank you to my patrons. You guys are absolutely awesome, and without your support, I wouldn't be able to make Maker Tales. And if you're enjoying what I'm making here, and you think I'm worthy of your support, I would love to see you there too. And don't forget that we have a Discord, and that's linked down in the description as well. Thank you for watching, keep making, and let the quest continue.